Atoms. They're the basic building blocks of the universe. But what are they? Well, let's talk about matter. Matter is basically, well, stuff. Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space. But if matter has mass and volume, what is it? To answer that question, we need to look past the microscopic world into the nano world.
What you see is a picture of the smallest particle you could call silicon. While this grainy image looks like nothing in particular, it is remarkable, since that lump you see is 117 and 6 tenths picometers wide. To give you an idea of how small that is, you could fit over a million of these atoms on the head of a pin.
No, not that type of pin.
Sorry.
This tiny particle is the basic unit of all matter, the atom. Amazingly, the atom is mostly empty space, since the outer layers of the atom are made of nearly massless but very energetic particles called electrons. Electrons carry an electrical charge, which is ultimately where we get our electricity from. Electrons carry a negative charge and are 1/1860th the mass of the particles in the center of the atom, which is called the nucleus. This negative charge of the electrons is balanced with the positively charged protons found in the nucleus.
Protons have an atomic mass of 1 and carry a positive charge, so they repel each other. In fact, if it weren't for the strong nuclear force, the nucleus would break apart. Another reason that the nucleus stays together is because of the presence of neutrons, which carry no charge.
Just like protons, neutrons have a mass of 1 atomic mass unit. They separate the charges of the protons so that they do not repel each other as strongly.
Now that we know the structure of an atom, we can look at the periodic table of the elements to find out what an atom of each element looks like. Back to the nano world. The number of protons in the nucleus determines the overall identity of the atom. The simplest element, hydrogen, has an atomic number of 1. This means there is only 1 proton in the nucleus. Now look at the outside of the atom. Zooming around is a single electron. The negative charge of that electron balances out the positive charge of the proton, giving the atom an overall neutral charge. Now if you look at helium with an atomic number of 2, we find that there are 2 protons in the nucleus. There are 2 electrons to balance out the charges of the protons. Wait, there's also 2 neutrons here. What are they there for? Oh, right, they're there to separate the positive charges of the protons. What this also does is give helium an atomic mass of 4. 2 for the protons, and 2 for the neutrons.
Now we can use the periodic table to make a prediction about what another element's atoms look like. Let's try carbon. Predict how many protons, neutrons, and electrons make up the carbon atom. That's correct. There are 6 protons and 6 neutrons in the nucleus, and 6 electrons zooming around the outside of the atom. Great job.
Well, now you know the structure of an atom. Congratulations. But it may be a while before you can know how to use that knowledge to make one of these.